Yo, what's good, yo, my boy?
What's
that's on the neighborhood, cuz.
Say word.
What up?
Yo, what's poppin' with y'all lashy asses? Nico in the building making aunties bat them lashes. Okay, I'm just foolin', let me cool it. See y'all listening? Join us as we get these big ups to black excellence. Okay. News you can use to uplift your kinfolk them. Feed them something different than that circus act on CNN. Just enough humor so it never be your boy. So welcome, Mr. Martin, this is Ethnic-ish.
I'm just saying, women are the backbone of our civilization, cuz. And for them to be mistreated, underpaid, and stressed, cuz, it's downright injustice, cuz, like Pac said, we gotta uplift and support our women, cuz. Did you know every dollar a man make, a woman makes 79 cents, cuz? Like, my mom had to try and feed me off 79 cents. Your mom had to try and feed you off 79 cents, cuz. And don't even get me started with hospital treatment, cuz. Like, they gotta do something, and they gotta close the gender gap on these finances, cuz.
Bring that fat ass over here. I wanna get it in my mouth. I wanna get it in my mouth. On your fat ass, gotta suck on that ass, baby. I gotta suck on that ass, yo. I'm talking, yo, I'm gonna spread the ass apart. Get my tongue in your ass, eating on your ass, oh, yo. I'm eating on you, eating on you, eating on your ass. I'm eating on your motherfucking ass. I wanna see you, baby, give me your ass. Yo, the whole ass, I'm gonna eat it with my tongue and mouth. Yo, you gotta do it, work that ass for daddy. Gotta work that ass for daddy. Go ahead, baby girl, gotta work it real good. Gotta work that ass with daddy.
You gotta work that ass with daddy. Work that ass with daddy when ya.
Oh, that's the juice, baby. Yo, I feel the juice in my mouth. Yo, the juice in your ass. Like Florida orange, baby. Yo, pulp free. Hell no, I need the pulp. Need a whole bunch of pulp in that goddamn ass, yo. Get on top of me. I see you, you're on top of me. I can't even see the rest of your body. Your ass is fat. Then you're sitting down, baby, on my face. I'm sucking your pussy and your ass in the same place. You gotta
work that ass for daddy.
Your ass is mine, bitch. Your ass is mine, gonna suck
gotta
on it.
Work that ass for daddy.
You gotta work it, baby. Gotta work it good. Love the ass.
Gotta work that ass for daddy.
You gotta work that ass. Please work down. Gotta. Work your ass, baby girl, with your goddamn ass.
Work that ass for daddy.
I see it and it's fat and I need it in my life. Gotta
crack-a-lackin'. It's your boy, Nico the Great, and we back on another episode of Ethnic-ish and More. This is number 25, 25, 25, 125, however you want to count it up. This is my 25th time sitting my black ass on this microphone and telling y'all the same shit every week in different forms, making y'all laugh and kick it. Tonight, I'm going to be without one of my special guests, and the other one is on the greatest of CP times, but she is low-key walking in the building as we speak, which is normal for On Yeezy. Shout out Melanie Maria Bud Talk STL, and I got On Ye finally walking in the building, y'all. And then we is going to Clap it up one more time for our special guest, a repeat offender. Of actually, it was the last guest on the pilot season of Ethnic Ish and More. The last time I did the in-person recording, y'all clap it up, shout it out for the homegirl Dasha Lyn of Soí.
Hey,
how are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
I'm glad you're back. Yay, what up? What it do?
Oh, this a little.
Well, nah, it's because of the spray. I said the same thing. I thought the nigga. Look, listen. So look. Now listen. Let me tell you my quarrel about it. Because the show before yours, that motherfucker was wet when I took it off from dude. And I was like, I look back, I said, Justin, I'm going to need you to go grab that shit. Then I seen him spray them hoes down. I'm like, you know what? That could be what it's from, because I thought the nigga was in this motherfucker licking on this bitch.
So
I'm like, bro, what the fuck you been doing spitting in the mic? I was like, you know, I don't want no parts of this shit, y'all. Look, because this motherfucker is nasty. Look, I want to thank and welcome all y'all ashy asses for coming back once again. Like I said, this is episode number 25. Tell me I need to send the info and the money, and I got you. This is episode, I don't know what episode is, but episode number 25, and y'all ask your ass to keep fucking with us. Make sure you tune in at www.mycitymymusic.com. Click the radio show and look for Ethnic Ish and More. It's a plethora of other shows, but start with mine first, and then you can work your way on down. Because long after my hour, you may not want to listen no more, so at least you got mine out the way. I appreciate it. Or you could download the damn Spreaker app, which is speaker with an R in there somewhere. Spreaker, listen to it. Download that. Look for Ethnic Ish and More. You can also look on like 22 other streaming platforms. Type in Ethnic Ish and More. And you'll see two separate setups. One is like the first 6 to 8 episodes. Then the rest of them is on the next one because the account thing happened. They had to split them up. They'll get it. I ain't really worried about it. As long as y'all niggas can find my shit, that's all I really be caring about. But yeah, you missed the first one.
Yeah,
the first one. It's this nigga named Mark Ribley. It's called Work That Ass for Daddy.
Oh no, I've heard him on Instagram.
That's my shit. That motherfucker. I'm like,
nah, I see it.
Listen,
it's sick. I'm instantly
you gotta excited. You gotta go find him on Apple Music, cause he got some motherfucking crack. I'm trying to tell y'all, that nigga got some crack. Listen to Mr. Mark Ribley and get the crack of the good songs, y'all. I want to shout out, and I'm going to throw the little DJ horn in there for my guest last week, my homeboy Mike Phillips, a.k.a. Mike Phil. Y'all already know our guest this week. We're going to clap it up for one more year. Ms. Dasha Lyn, the CEO and owner of Soy and Soy Essentials.
We'll
do a little razzle-dazzle, talk about that a little bit later. You know how that go. And my first little question thing I got before I start talking some other shit. They got a versus battle tonight, which I'm kindly upset that I'm here for it, but I pay money to be here. So I'm going to have to watch the replay on YouTube. But it's DMX and Snoop Dogg.
I mean, Snoop got that.
I'm not saying that. No, don't discount DMX.
I did it.
In them Rough Rider days.
He did not.
Snoop got hella fire his, but a lot of them be consistent of always other people. DMX
got
some motherfucking
shit on his own.
DMX just on crack. Okay, that's what just fuck him.
That's
my uncle though. Mm-hmm. That's my uncle. I'm bringing him back. I'm trying to make him a guest on the show. I'm gonna keep reaching out to his ass too. I ain't never hit him up once yet. But starting today, Uncle DMX, I'm trying to bring you to St. Louis. I'm trying to get you to open up at Lincoln Homecoming. We're gonna make it happen, Uncle X. I'm gonna revive your career, and we're gonna make sure you good, bro. I'm gonna let them niggas tell you that you beat Snoop tonight. That nigga gonna play some heat though. That shit gonna be fun.
Yeah, that's
I just hope only
fun.
One of them high.
Man, they both gonna be high.
One of them only needs to be high.
But they both gonna be high.
But DMX can go to jail for his high. The other one can't. So one of them on probation parole. The other one is fine and do what he wants to. X, you tired of going to rehab? When you got to keep checking yourself in by yourself, I mean, you need to get your shit together, brother. Stop. Come on, X. Don't do no crack before this show.
Well, I'm sure he will.
Don't go out there too. Don't get on that prank
before you perform.
Yeah, but weed keeps me at a level pace. I don't stop doing weed.
Exactly.
Well, you know what? I don't kick it around niggas. I don't know too many niggas that just smoke crack on their free own will and accord. So I don't know how niggas just gonna normally. I feel like he's gonna be. Nah, but I don't think he started smoking crack till he started downfall. I hope he wasn't smoking crack in the good days. I think he was doing coke then. When he was normal, he was doing coke. I don't know how. Yeah, because you can't be doing crack acting. I'll take it back.
You can't be doing crack.
I just don't feel like, think about you, how the most crackheads you see.
Yeah.
How much of them can control their mannerisms and all that shit? They be
looking like a motherfucker, though.
I don't see, no, all that good for is stealing.
And cleaning.
Yeah, but and they'll do it for the lowest.
For the lowest of the low.
I had a nigga at the gas station. Like, fam, let me cut out. Your windows look dirty. I was going to give him the change without him washing. He's like, but I don't feel right. Let me clean your window. I was like, nigga, you want to be a slave? You do what you do. I got a couple things to change and I got a single dollar. I hope that gets you on the next bus. I don't know if they take pennies, though.
I
tried to give him the money for free. He wanted to work for it. That was his free will in the pool. I ain't had nothing to do with that.
It was.
Well, that's all right with me, though. I ain't gonna trip about it. But I gotta look for my little favorite song thing because I didn't put it on this motherfucker. Being like, am I the same motherfucker?
Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Is you drunk? Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Hold on. Now you drunk. Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Now you drunk. Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Is you drunk? Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Hold on. Now you drunk. Is you stupid? Is you dumb?
And I ate it all day.
Is you stupid? Is you dumb? Now you drunk.
Hey. I do.
So, my person, this is like a second repeat offender. He was just on here about maybe a week and a half ago, Mr. Kanye West. This time he said some wild shit. I just thought it was super random, which I understand everybody got their reasons, but it's like the time and place to say it. I don't knock nobody for what they feel and how they feel on shit, because everybody's opinion be different to yours. But I'll be feeling like he be choosing the wrong time and platforms to be saying his shit. And my man's, that's only his downfall. He chooses the wrong time to when he want to freely spit his shit off.
Right.
Like, you at this, it looked like some type of a rally of some sort. And the only clip part I saw him, first off, I saw him going off on some black woman because she had a mask on and that motherfucker, it was hella non-social distancing. He's like, we don't even know who you are. You got a mask on. Like, how you going to shame somebody for doing what y'all been telling us to do? One stupid moment. And then the other one where he said, and I ain't going to say I quote because I probably need to re-listen to it, but I know he said most of this verbatim damn near. So that's the difference, y'all. Verbatim damn near means I almost got it correct. It ain't all the way, so he can't sue me for it. I'm just let y'all know, if you ever see me say something, if I type out verbatim damn near, that means I'm close to what the nigga said, but it may not be right. You do your fact checking.
Verbatim damn near.
Yeah, that's my new one. I come up with a lot of words. I'm going to start patenting my shit. But I'll let y'all have that one. Verbatim that's damn okay. Near. Remember that when y'all, I'm going to put it on t-shirt. Verbatim damn near. That sound good. Oh, man, that sound like a clothing line. Verbatim damn near. It's French. Don't worry about my shit. Now, you pick a French word.
Tell them, please. Can somebody
do my thing?
You know how you.
That's why I'm bring y'all on the show. Y'all be getting them like that.
It's a bad thing, Jenny.
Kanye said Harriet Tubman didn't do anything but free the slaves to go work for other white people. Now, Mr. Kanye, I don't think that was the right time to bring that up if you felt that way.
No.
You out here trying to, like, gain voters and talk to people. I feel like he's saying what he wants to because Trump did that shit. He just like, shit, I'm black. But his shit always work against us when he say it. It'll never be like, let me talk about how white people do X, Y, and Z or how they do X, Y, and Z. He shoot his shit at us every chance he get. And then I seen a nigga get on Twitter and just start tweaking. Like, talking bad about his wife and all type of other shit. Like, she should have aborted the baby. And, like, some wild, crazy shit.
Oh, did he get hacked?
No, that was Kanye. You know, he be having this. I think he's diagnosed with bipolar. Oh. So, if a nigga don't take his medicine, he gonna do some other shit. I've seen people not take their medicine and do some wild shit. And I think that's the level that Kanye on. So, we're gonna pray for him in that aspect. But, bro, just pick and choose your timing for when you gonna do this wild shit. It ain't always the right time. It's not.
It's not. It's never an opportune time for you.
Like, just chill, bro.
So unfortunate.
Yeah, you be doing some other shit with your goofy ass.
Like, hella goofy.
Get your shit to motherfucking together, and I need you to stop doing all the stupidest.
And the drovedness.
Look at all of that shit, and man.
Man, you hella drove.
Like, you get on my motherfucking nerves, bro. Hella drove. So look, we're going to go on a little quick commercial break. As y'all didn't know, for those that was listening, the music selection tonight is Black People's Favorite White People Music.
Ow!
And I made a whole post about it. And I'm going to do it.
He ain't put my shit on her.
I did because I saw your shit late. Yeah, it took me. It was. I didn't expect.
I know you expect so many responses.
It looked crazy, though. A lot of them songs I didn't even take off there. But what I'm going to do it is I'll save the post so I can do it. Down the line, down another episode, you're gonna have part two, three, four.
That motherfucker's hella reply. Because the last you only spent. You only.
Look, I knew you put something that I fucking wanted and I couldn't remember because I couldn't find it. I tried to scroll through and I was like, by the time I'll just have put some shit on. Like, so that's why I saved it.
Boy,
so
I'm like, you know what?
That's my shit.
That's
my shit because I was living in Iowa and I put my Kendrick Lamar CD in the Ford Explorer I had and that motherfucker fucked up. So I could never get the CD out. So all I had to do was listen to the radio
right now.
And they only play white people music in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. I learned every pop song that was on that station because I know how to subconsciously learn music. Look, I know Latch word for motherfucking word.
Me too.
I know the words to every goddamn song.
Really, you don't do you?
I be singing.
That don't matter. That's all that matters. As long as you feel
it,
that's all that matters. So look, I'm gonna drop this song called "Somebody That I Used to Know." I don't know the nigga name. I said like got ye, got yo. I ain't feel like one. I was gonna go. That's what it looked like. Go ahead. I don't know what that motherfucker is.
Oh, we so funny for this shit because we straight cracking. Like some of that.
And then
music.
The song after that shit, they y'all probably never heard of it. After I play this next song, y'all need to look up the band. It's a white funk band named Tuxedo.
Okay.
They fired.
Side
I didn't know they was white till I looked them up. And that's when the shit be fuck you up. You ever hear a song? You like, damn, this nigga got some songs. You look it up.
Yeah, you look it up, you be like, damn.
So I felt about Harlow. Look, I was just going to say, that's how I felt about Jack Harlow. I was like, okay, this nigga cold. I looked him up and said, I'll be motherfucking dead.
I know, me too. I was not ready for it. It's all good.
I used to be thinking about that back in the day. Like, well, I wasn't back then, but when the racism time was hella strong.
My ass.
But look, you think about when racism was hella strong. White people listen to the radio. They hear this fire-ass song. They be like, ooh, this is a goddamn bop. And then they fuck around, see the music video, and be like, goddamn nigga.
They did. What's his name like that? Lil Nas X. When they found out dude was black, they was like, oh.
Then it made
black
gay
dude. Then he got the contract rewrangled. They was
pissed. They was irate, goddamn.
Yeah, that was pissed.
They was like, this nigga. Because that was not only is he a nigga, he's a damn nigga and he's a homo. That's the first thing them country
people said. Billy Ray Cyrus on that motherfucker.
That's what made it worse.
He's my favorite motherfucker.
Look, Park, low key. Look, he gets come on here and that bitch like, look,
they was pissed.
That's how I felt when I was downtown skating the Kena Plaza and a nigga shot through that bitch like Django on a goddamn horse.
Oh,
I seen him pull up. He went to Lincoln. I think the nigga name's Eric, but I ain't say nothing to him because I wasn't for sure because he did. You know, he one of them Lincoln niggas that did like a semester. But you remember from seeing them around the way. I know a lot of, they be having the most fun times in stores.
Yeah, they do.
They like, bro, I did all this. I'm like, bro, where you going from? Like, I was there for fall 13. I'm like, oh, how long? Just fall 13. I'm like, damn, boy, how you got all them stories in fucking 6 months?
That was
not even a full six, nigga. That's 4 months.
Every day in Lincoln. Every single day.
And you ain't go to no class. That's why you didn't make it to the second semester. So that's why I'm going to play this music before I start talking about them niggas. Because it's a lot of them and I can go on and on and on.
pursuing, baby. You know, well, the shit might hit the fan.
Wow, 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 wow.
Just
getting
tall on your ass.
Girl, you ain't getting tall. That's C high.
Shit it up.
That's C high, nigga.
Zip it and throw it away.
You 30. Them heights ain't going no more.
Yeah, he normally put the pillow on the
No, I think the chair was switched around. That chair.
Oh, I'm about to say.
Yeah, that chair switched around. Look, y'all. I know y'all heard them goddamn songs. That's somebody that I used to know put me in a place. If it wasn't for y'all niggas, I would have put it on repeat.
It was a place I used to
know. Anytime I be at the crib, I used to put it on repeat. That shit be slamming. And that goddamn Two Wrongs by Tuxedo. Y'all, everybody probably wouldn't listen, but people listening, that's the shit. That's my shit. You gotta hear the other songs. It's hella
ugly. Pitch, you ain't play my shit. You need to revamp this.
Look, I'll make
it. I feel a certain type
of
way.
Listen, nigga, I'm coming up with more.
I'm looking at all songs that I don't recognize. No, I'm just fucking with you.
So I'm trying to put y'all on. I'm trying to put y'all niggas on.
It is.
I'll be making some shit. Some fire
shit.
You
put me on that sir, whole album, smack.
Look.
Chasing
Summer, smell you. That's a push and play.
V-I-B-E.
I'm the type of nigga look for push and play albums. I want to push your shit and be able to go clean. I shouldn't have to keep changing your songs.
I mean, yeah, I want to clean minutes. Off your shit on God.
I
want
to keep changing your songs, you ain't for me.
Did you listen to this? Who? Baby, did I listen to it?
I haven't done so yet.
Do I outplay it? Do I play it too much? Yes, I probably do.
I haven't listened to it yet, but I heard it was
fire. When I said she was in the lab,
yeah, I fucks with
like dead ass. She was in the lab. She was sleeping in that.
Women make the best R&B music to me. She was always listening to them.
She got a baby daddy on her kid.
He rapping and shit.
He rapping.
He a decent little rapper. Shit, he didn't get too much basketball time now, so you might as well use them in
Dallas.
She wrote it for. Yeah, she did the thing. She did the thing. Yeah.
So look, y'all. It's episode 25.
Oh, damn, we motherfucking OG.
We 25 in
this. Ethnic Asian Moore is an OG, ho.
OG. Essentially Soy.
Beautiful.
Is the name of the episode today.
I love that.
And usually, y'all, when we come back, we get plugged in with my dog, Melanie Marie. I think she had a meet and greet for the Cornell class that she in. She said something about a class.
Good.
She shot me a text a couple hours ago.
Beautiful.
I was like, cool. Just let me know. I don't care.
As long as I know.
I don't be caring if they don't show up. I just be wanting to know so I know ain't nothing happened.
Right.
Because usually y'all will pop up.
Yes.
So if I don't get no text.
I be late just a little.
But if I don't get no text,
about 10 minutes,
I don't be worried about you
15
not coming.
Minutes.
I'll be thinking something happened to you on the way to the motherfucking. I'll be like,
right, I feel
nah,
you.
I gotta go to the
you
show.
Just a concerned uncle.
Check. Yeah, I am. I'm like that every once in a while. But since we can't get plugged in with Melanie Marie, we're going to clap it up. As Yayo the General pops her shit and presents Good Morning Beautiful.
What did do, baby? Oh my goodness, I miss y'all so much. First of all, last week I had to take the week off because I just need a self-care day. Sometimes y'all just really have to take your time and just be with yourself. Do the things that you want to do, whether it's take a hot-ass bath and stand that bitch for 3 hours till you prune, whether it's to watch your favorite shows. Well, it ain't about you. I'm really focusing on my ladies.
Cause that's what I need.
Damn, we don't get self-care days either?
Y'all do, though. But I'm just saying, like, for real, we be moving, Nico, for real. You do. You get a day. You get your hair cut. You ain't gonna take no bath.
I'm finna get this haircut. I'm y'all. Yeah, come on, beard this week.
You is not. I don't believe that shit. You gonna put it in a plastic Ziploc bag?
I'm finna regrow it and do it back out. Cause then I ain't really take care of it for real. My shit just grow like this.
What if you don't put some some olive oil on that shit?
My shit grow so motherfucking fast. Like, I'm not finna be bald faced.
Okay.
I ain't did that shit since I ain't had one.
Okay, then.
I was going to block him until it grew back.
Right. Y'all gonna see this looking creepy.
Y'all going to see this beard off. Y'all going to be like, damn, I ain't
looking so creepy.
Up under that motherfucker. This motherfucker going to be fine. I'm going to post a hella pictures with it. Yeah.
So, like, I just feel like I just had to put that out there. The reason why I was absent, but I missed you guys so much. So, today I want to talk about Good Morning Beautiful. Now, as you guys know, as fine as I am, unfortunately, I'm single. Hello. So, when I meet people, you know, I try to be open-minded and, you know, meet guys at different places that I might slide. You know, it's COVID. You don't know if that nigga got some fucked up teeth behind that mask. You know what I'm saying? You don't know things like that. But I'm open-minded. So, why is it that as soon as I meet somebody, boom, the next day he texts me, good morning, beautiful. First of all, I am not beautiful in the morning. I am a crust monster, okay?
Y'all so motherfucking irky. It's like, we can't text you good morning, beautiful.
No,
if
because
we don't
that's...
text you, then y'all be mad we don't send no goddamn text message.
Ooh, no, seriously. It's not about that. I want you to be authentic. So how about you text me, rise and shine with your crusty ass. Like, that would really ignite my flame. I'd be like, oh, shit, I'm up. What's up? You know?
Everybody
but
instead,
you want to say good morning, beautiful.
I mean, I don't send no good morning, beautiful.
Exactly. Thank you. That shit lame. But every nigga sending you good morning, beautiful. Or maybe it's just me. I know I'm fine, but not when I wake up in the morning. That's just the damn truth. I look like a young bull. With five braids to the bag.
Well, not like the nigga.
In cuckabug.
It'd be different if he woke up next to you and said that.
But
shit,
that's not that's what I'm saying.
But no, she's saying it's routine. It's like, very you already routine. Know that you're going to get it.
Yes, thank you. There you go, sis. Now it brings us back. So you already know you're going to get that same type of routine, that same type of character. Then boom, y'all talking for a week. And what? How long is it going to take for us to make, you going to make a plan or no? Because you finna get next. Because now you text a good morning, beautiful.
Oh, a plan, like for what?
To do something.
Oh, okay. No, okay. That's what I was making sure.
That's what I'm saying.
I was making sure that's what you were talking
about.
I didn't know. That's why I asked.
Yes.
I don't know. That's why I'm inquiring.
It's because you don't make plans. But go ahead.
You're damn lucky. You're lucky. I got plans this weekend.
Right. Just some, thank you. But some plans. Like, you know, say, okay, we should. How long should I be texting your ass before somebody make a plan?
Well, okay. Now I get what you said.
You see
what I'm
saying?
Heard plans. So I'm like, what you, I thought you meant like plan. Like, nigga, what?
Yeah, so I feel like.
I get that. No, yeah. In a week, yeah. If I'm fucks with you.
Thank you. So you must not be interested when you steady sending me these empty text messages.
You wasting my time.
You wasting my time because you're empty. So another example. Okay, that motherfucker say good morning before. Okay, good morning. How are you? My day is good. Boom. Is that the end of the conversation? Because I ain't finna put
some
no energy in shit. Because sometimes I put too much energy. I'm like, well, how are you? You know, how was your day? Do you have any plans for the week? You got some errands? This motherfucker, nah, I'm just chill. Oh, what? Get the fuck off my phone then, because you don't have any substance at this point.
No, I feel that because I'm a communicator, so I know how to. If
and you a
talk
Pisces,
on the phone,
ain't you?
Yeah.
Pisces is
if
really
I,
good
if
water
either
signs.
We on the phone talking, I can talk to you, or
see,
I can text
I would appreciate. Yeah, call me. Don't send me them empty ass texts because texts sometimes you know it's easily misread.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I just feel like a lot of guys are very empty. They lack substance, and they on that bullshit. And within a week, I kind of feel like, okay, we ain't hung out, we ain't went out to
you
eat.
Wasting my time.
You're
yeah.
wasting my whole
no, I feel
entire
that.
Time.
I feel that. Yeah, eventually do something. If I fucks with you, we can go kick it.
Like, and it just brings me to, do they want us to take more initiative? Because I really am old-fashioned. I want to be courted.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't feel like I should have to, you know, sometimes it's okay to, you want, you know, to show interest. But what initiative should I take? If you know what I'm saying, like, cause I hate having to tell people, y'all be telling these niggas to fuck off. Oh, I'm gonna be sleeping for a long time. Oh, man. Because I just
got that energy. I ain't telling nobody shit. Like, I just don't feel like. I mean, once you had that, if y'all fucks with each other, had that conversation.
Yeah, no, it didn't even get to that point, though.
But I'm going to talk in the beginning. In the beginning, though, it's super simple.
These don't even, these be empty. It don't have nothing.
All right, what you got going this weekend? Nothing? Okay, cool. Well, shit, I ain't got nothing either.
See, you don't even get that far, though, Nico.
Well, I can't help that. I can't help that. I'm a different nigga.
No, but I'm just telling what she's talking about.
But I feel what y'all saying.
You don't even get to that point and be like, nothing.
Okay, so now this is my question. Is it all the niggas that
you
be texting doing that?
And I'm deleting three.
Is it all the niggas you be texting that be doing that, though?
First of all, I don't even have niggas. So I repeat, I'm single.
Okay, that don't, okay, single. Shit.
But yeah,
single,
I got a couple little, I got a couple little oops that want to hit me up on the text like, hey. Or they hit me with the, hey, stranger. I don't initiate texts with niggas because they will not text you back. And they don't be keeping it 100. These are the guys that I've come across. So I don't initiate texts. You ain't gonna never, unless you, I fuck with you. You somebody that I care about. But we fuck around. If somebody I care about, ain't gonna be nobody I just met for real. Because these niggas don't, they don't show you no love.
I just start finding niggas that know how to talk. I don't know.
Yeah, see, and then we in the COVID era. How the fuck are we planning to do that?
Shit, this is the greatest time to talk shit.
Shit.
This is shit.
But the thing is, if you lack substance, you're wasting my time because we're not talking about nothing. It's just back and forth.
Look,
and
I feel that. I can't. I feel that. Some niggas don't know how to hold no conversation. I know how to do that. We face to face. I could definitely, we're not going to sit there and just be quiet.
It's dominating at this point. It's a lot of them. I don't even know. It make you want
to stop. Some of them niggas don't be talking because the motherfuckers that they be fucking with don't be inquiring them to do that much.
If you kick
with a whole bunch of women that don't require you to talk that much, the motherfuckers let you say a little bit. You do what you need to do with them to go about your business. At that point, you feel like everybody with that shit. Or that's what you think you are picking up every time.
Yeah.
If I talk to a motherfucker that ain't got no good conversation, I'll stop texting you.
I'm glad. Me too. That shit don't faze me at all. But I have to tell you, not if you don't keep texting me and you see that this ain't, you know, you don't got no substance, I'm gonna tell you, nah, this dry.
I don't even give you that much. I'll just stop texting you.
Yeah, man. I won't hit up no more.
I'll just stop texting your ass. I don't need to get no disclaimer. You know your conversation suck. I ain't the person that didn't told you.
Especially when they hit you with the high stranger. Oh yeah, I need you to put some energy behind that
shit. Only time I text that shit. I'll just checking on motherfuckers. And I really don't be wanting shit because I laugh.
That's the thing. Niggas don't be wanting it.
But.
Babe, when I say they be on shit and nothing,
he's
nothing
is
shit.
Yes. I said when I text that, it be to somebody, I really, but we just cool.
We're not saying you, saying. Nico, but you have to understand shit.
But I get what y'all say.
Of women out here. It ain't, y'all men, it's not that many of y'all. I feel like a lot of the brothers is locked up. The covers, they're dead. Like shit. Hey,
then I be thinking too, like texting is like writing something. Some of y'all not past that.
Exactly.
So if not, pick up the phone
and call. FaceTime, that's cool. Do y'all call them niggas,
or do y'all always wait on these niggas to do the first thing?
My thing is, it's a fine line between calling it now. I feel like I'm chasing you. Hell no, I'm not finna chase no man.
I understand. Nobody told you to chase nobody.
No, it's
but it's some people that walk around thinking I'm not gonna call no nigga.
No, it ain't even that.
No nigga, then they wonder why I don't nobody communicate.
No. Definitely initiate, and I definitely send a text. I'm not saying it like that. But when I do it, I feel like motherfuckers be acting foul. Like, they feel like they got that ball in their court. When I'm just trying to express some interest and give some energy to get that back, I don't never get the energy that I put out. So I stop putting out that fucking energy.
Then they be like,
I feel that.
Yeah.
I feel that. You know what I'm saying? If the vibe don't match, then I'm just going
to
let that shit.
It's time to get nexted.
Drizzle out.
But now I keep nexting it. But I can't, it's fine. I'm going to just stay fine. It is what it is at this point. But I just want to not know if guys don't really like to text, but they be hitting me with that dry shit and I be letting them know.
Look, I'd rather text a motherfucker because it's easier to stop texting.
It is.
Like, it's easier to stop texting than me find an excuse to get off the phone.
Shoot your name for me?
All
right.
I'll call you right back.
Right,
I'll call you back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now my client about to walk in.
I mean, you got a good, solid excuse. I'll just be like, huh, let me call you right back.
Then, for real.
They'll be like, Sean ain't even there this week. It was the dog. Yeah, I just don't. But I don't talk on the phone that often. And the people I do talk to on the phone, it's all FaceTime.
Okay.
So I feel like, shit, what's that creative? Yeah, what the hell? We just visually talk, unless it's something quick. I'd rather see your expression. It's just like, yeah.
I don't mind
that.
Talking on the phone. But yeah, that dry shit dead, though.
No, I feel that. If you dry, now, you're going to be dry throughout the entire time.
Like, we want a little bit more. I'm not asking for a motherfucker to do this and that. I'm not no city girl. You know what I'm saying? So that ain't what I'm looking for. I want a companion and somebody who I could actually build a friendship with. These niggas won't even let you be their friend because they so motherfucking whack. My fucks with my friends.
Oh, no, yeah.
I love my homegirls.
I'm the women that I'm just cool with. That I don't be on shit, ain't never trying that. We just literally sit, text, or talk on the phone. I don't want to be on shit with y'all. I don't look at y'all.
I know what it is. These niggas be trying to fuck.
They do. They do. They just don't got the game.
They don't even got the words, though.
I mean, but you.
They just don't know hoes.
But that's what, if niggas knew.
It's
if niggas knew
pussy.
If they just be themselves, that shit is already determined
They don't even know who they say.
It's already determined for you. She know if she thinking about it or thought about giving it up. You got the ball in your court to fuck that up.
Yeah.
By either not doing right or just being a goofy, or you trying to press the situation. Don't know one deal with no nigga that be just on that all the time. It's like, hey, shit, what's up, nothing.
I'm glad you was on my same frequency.
You like, what's your birthday? It's March.
I thought it was just you me. Like, I'm like, no. It's just, I just know too many beautiful, fine-ass women who just doing, like you said, not saying, okay, I know women personally that really, I feel like should have a man. Like, I feel like
you can't say that, though.
No, because I'm serious. All,
she's saying that people that she knows.
That but I know.
But it's not always us. A lot of y'all are blame us and don't never take a look in the mirror to why you keep dealing with that same situation.
That is true. But as we get older, we know how to cut them situations short. I'm saying it's women not right all now. Y'all. Early 30s. I know. I'm talking about the personal friends that I have. These are really good, hardworking women. And they have great personalities. They ain't stuck up. They ain't no hoes. Like, they straight good. They good women to be with, honestly. And I just feel like that shit crazy. Like, it ain't just me. It's just me and the bummer.
So your homegirl, so you gonna feel that way about them. You ain't never been in a relationship with them. That's maybe true. Niggas had a better relationship with them. Like, man, y'all be doing this, this, and that. You always gotta see
I don't
it.
See it, though.
Because you ain't in a relationship with
them. I feel you.
That your homegirl is always, and if y'all solid, y'all always.
The common denominator to me is the lame-ass niggas that motherfuckers is meeting. That's just the bottom line.
Or do it be the common denominator, some of be some of y'all. Shit. If you the one person between 10 niggas that all was lame, it's 1 out of 10.
But my thing is, how do you get to know me? 10
niggas ain't always got the same.
How do you get to know me to figure out how I am if we don't get past this? What you doing? What you doing? What you doing? What you doing?
And I feel that 100% everybody
ain't. So what, she ain't texting back fast enough? She ain't texting back the right stuff?
I can't speak for every nigga. I can only speak for me. Because that's the difference. My opinion always gonna come from a nigga that do the shit y'all be wrong. My opinion always come from the spot of a nigga that do the shit I know women do. They want somebody that's gonna talk. They want somebody that's gonna fuck with them. I come from that
and
aspect.
And you see where you come from, Nico. Your parents are still hella together. Period. Let's stop there.
But that ain't everybody. That's an excuse after a while, though.
But me and my brother was just talking about that because we came from a two-family household. You know, we had both our mom and our daddy. And we said that it's kind of a gift and a curse because a lot of people didn't have that. You know what I'm saying? They didn't have that structure. They are
fucking broken. That's all that I'm saying. I know what you're saying. I'm speaking more surface level of the women that I know. I feel like it's a lot of single women out here. Or if they not single, they in a relationship with a lame-ass nigga who they really just dirt with because that's just a piece of a man. That's always gonna be my passion behind this shit fault. Until I see something different. That's their fault for sure.
That's they
because a real nigga gonna be outside.
If you gonna let me, if you stay with a nigga that ain't on shit, you let him do what he want to, and he continue to do that shit, you accept it. So why he gonna stop doing what you accept?
Yeah.
So. Niggas, get y'all shit together.
Yeah, that was lit, though.
Ladies,
period.
get y'all shit together, too.
Everybody get
y'all shit together.
You take yourself, Kurt, and my motherfucker gonna look at you and tell you that you take care of yourself. Don't fuck with nobody that ain't taking care of themselves, because, baby, they ain't gonna take care of you.
That's a fact, and we got another track to play before we holler at Dasha Lyn. And get to talk about Soy Central. I ain't even gotta say this motherfucking name, because y'all niggas know it.
I'm weak.
God damn, Justin Timberlake and Nim. I had another song, y'all, that we running down the time. I was gonna play my motherfucking Hair There, Delilah, but I'm gonna play that shit next time because that's my shit. Yeah, I fucks with that shit. That's a bop. I was singing it all night. Yes. I was singing my name, my dog, listen. But we back. Ethnic Ishimori. It's your boy Nico the Great, and I got one half of the co host tandem.
The one your girl, Yayo the General.
And we about to chop it up. And clap it up one more game for the wonderful Dasha Lyn. Let me retail brand. So, is it Soy Essential?
Correct.
Soy Essential.
Soy Essential.
So, Miss Dasha Lyn, this is not your first go round on here. So, I'm going to ask you a question that I asked you before. And for the people that didn't watch and the people that don't know, she was the last episode, the final episode of the pilot version of Ethnic Ishimori. When I first tried this shit out.
Yeah.
Last person I recorded, our first time ever meeting in person, was our interview.
Yeah.
Oh, that's it.
Which was the same with Melanie, but this was the last one. And we did it in Del Mar Loop.
Yeah.
It was hella cool. It was hella dope. So for those who didn't go back and watch that one, and for those who are not tuned in, tell our listeners a little about yourself and what you do.
So my name is Dasha Lyn. I am, of course, from St. Louis. I am a licensed manicurist, and I have a suite inside of Sheer Magic, which is in the Central West End. I specialize in pedicures and natural nails, also male nail care.
Yes. Cool. Get your nails done, Nico. You heard what she said.
Yeah, y'all supposed to be in go.
He's scared.
Girl,
he's
no. Scared. I'm like,
y'all been saying when I'm a, when can boy. I go? You told me I get
you too. So what's been going on with Soy Essentials since our last interview?
So since the last interview, I want to say the last interview I was finishing up, I was at I switched locations. So I'm now in the Central West End. Awesome. I've been taking classes since quarantine because I have two more classes left and I'll be a certified medical nail technician.
Yes, that's awesome.
And then I've also been working on retail products for the brand, and that's where Soy Essentials came from.
Okay.
And that's a full line of candles, body scrubs, yes. Body butters. Oh, yeah, here you go.
We need that. I show them what's going to
bring. And a few other things. She'll get us for. And it's here's the other one right here.
Oh, this smells amazing.
Look, that shit's
oh
some next level
God.
Smell.
I know, right?
They look like the good slow burning candles, too. Because them motherfuckers from Walmart, I burned that bitch at 6 by 6:05.
Peach.
That shit is pure juice.
It's that soy is. Wax.
Ooh, yep. Fancy.
Oh, that is. That's very
illustrious.
Very wired.
She said, I don't have wax, nigga. Very. I have soy wax. Ooh. Do you spell it with the S?
No.
Oh, come on. You gotta flex on niggas. So well, they know the real spelling, but you can spell it the way you want to on your thing and then just put the parentheses with the real word. Come on, brand it for yourself. I ain't gonna try. So look, since we was talking about the quarantine, in what ways during this pandemic have you been able to further progress your business and skill sets needed for your business?
So since the quarantine and the whole pandemic, I actually had time to sit down. Like for a lot of people, this has been a horrible situation for them. But for me, like I'm grateful for quarantine because if not, I would have never came out with Soy Essentials, which is the retail product. I wouldn't have had time to actually do my classes and advance my knowledge, you know, my skill set or whatever. So for me, this was like a pivot point in my business. Like it took me to the next level and it definitely set me up for better things to come.
Yes, I heard that. I love that. You're so true because it has been horrible for most people, but some people have really benefited from the opportunity to sit down and to be forced into their own creativity.
Yeah,
because
I'm always like, I'm always on the go.
It's always something going on.
Now, I'm not going to lie, the first 2 weeks, I was going crazy. I'm like, what? Oh my God, what am I about to do? What am I about to do? I had to figure it out.
Your business rely being up on people.
I'm a service-based business. But then it also, I had this happen to like retail products, marketing, like visual things like that. Definitely. So it basically tapped into my other side of creativity.
I love it. And that leads me to the next question. What made you want to start venturing into retail, Soy Essentials?
And that's, from the beginning, I knew I wanted a full brand. I don't want to just be in a salon, you know, in somebody else's salon.
Absolutely.
Like, I want a full brand. I want a full business to where I'm able to employ people and things like that.
Exactly.
And
I love that.
So when you go to spas, they have retail products. They have lotions. They have polishes. So I'm like, well, if they can do it, why come I can't do it?
Damn, to the right.
I always wanted it to be natural, too, because a lot of them have different additives and things like that, chemicals. So this was my time. I actually got to bring my idea to life type of thing.
Because
if not, I would have still just been thinking about it.
You get the time to sit.
You put that into
research.
Action.
And with most of your time, be dealing with people all of that time with the straight research.
Yeah, and the thing was, I was wrecking my. I've been researching since I've been in school, so it's like it's been on my board to do it.
To do it.
But the time to actually like manufacture stuff, put stuff together.
Where
it's gonna come from? Exactly.
And it done came.
And I'm grateful for it.
It did.
That's what's up. So. What are some upcoming things for Soy and Soy Essential?
So, this Saturday, I will be releasing the candle line.
Yes.
There's Serene and Sweet. There's Strawberry Peace. You have Ginger Twist. And then Saturdays, but it's spelled S-A-T-U-R-D-A-Z-E. So, it's like a fresh thing.
It's fresh,
definitely. It's like a fresh thing.
Okay.
So, I'll be releasing those Saturday. And then in August, I'll have some retail products that are like... what would you say, like decor items that go with the candles or whatever, and then I'll be releasing the scrubs in August.
Oh, that's lit. Yes, I love your timeline. That's going to be perfect. And the fact that you said they're natural, that adds a little bit something unique about it. So that's dope.
And that shit smell like they strong smelling.
Yes, I love
it. Through the container and everything.
Yeah. That's the type I like of the three-wick candles, too.
I do, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I take deep baths. But tell our viewers and listeners where they can find you and information about your company.
So I am on Facebook and Instagram at Soy, S-O-I-S-T-L. And then I also have my own website, which is www.soystl.com. My booking information, you have details and prices online as well.
Beautiful.
That's what's
yes,
up.
Yes.
Y'all clap it up.
That's lit.
Absolutely.
Coming on here doing
so
that
refreshing.
Thing.
I
like
it. So
and
nice
that's
to
the best
you.
Thing because she's the second person that done got to do a repeat episode. Yeah. We had Chad. Chad coincidentally did his repeat episode 2 days before the 1 year anniversary of me starting this show.
Oh, that's dope.
And he was the first episode.
Oh, that's dope.
I had no idea until Facebook memory sent me the thing. I had no idea when I did the first episode.
That's dope.
I just knew it was sometime, and I'm like, damn, that's a hella coincidence. So to have another person, I don't know. I'm trying to get some more of y'all. I don't know. No? Did I have somebody else? No, I do not. So it's y'all too right now. So that's what's up, y'all. So look, we're going to go on another little commercial break, then we're going to get about this Mickey Ficky.
Period.
I got to play another song that I like. I didn't put it on the goddamn paper. Shut your ass up. Shut your goddamn ass up.
It would be fun. I can't stay on your life.
it grows. You spend more than you own. Well, Papa always said to me, well, keep a close eye on your authority.
thing. 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 4. We out this mother. What's good, y'all?
This is for real.
Y'all get y'all sister soldier moment on. I ain't got nothing to do with that, y'all. They ain't got nothing to do with me. I'm sitting in the corner, y'all. Y'all niggas ain't shit. That's all I hear, y'all. Y'all niggas ain't shit.
The ones that we have encountered. I'm trying to say, if the good ones, could they come out of hiding, please? Come out of hiding.
Y'all niggas ain't shit. That's all I've been
hearing. I didn't say that.
I'm telling
the niggas that we've met have been lame and not shit.
Everybody, all the homegirls I got, they all be like, these niggas ain't shit. These niggas don't be.
No, that we're actually really like trying to figure
I
out.
I believe y'all. If, look, my whole thing is if two people agree, it's true.
Fuck yeah. We dead ass, no cap.
That's all right. That's why I ain't mocking
beautiful
y'all.
Businesswoman, got
y'all niggas
shit.
Ain't shit.
Y'all niggas not shit. If y'all intimidated, put your fucking big boy drawers on, nigga.
Yeah, put them on. Shit, that shit don't faze me.
Say, hey, how you doing, Miss Lady? You motherfuckers don't even know how to talk.
I mean, yeah, that sucks. I don't shoot my shot in person too often, too. That's just happen.
You ain't got to shoot your shot. You
and it's not because I'm not, like, scared.
Hello,
it just don't happen.
So what make you shoot your shot?
Shit, now if I feel it, like if I'm fucking with
you. So you ain't never been out like at a grocery store or nothing and want to speak to somebody?
I'll be at the grocery store. I get the fuck in and out. I don't be trying to talk to nobody.
I feel you.
I'm antisocial.
That's why I'm trying to be at the grocery store, library, or something. But anyway, go on here. Come on. Let's go. Justin Ready.
I've been there to get a book.
Justin
Ready. I ain't gonna try to holler at your ass. Check out my goddamn read on.
I read. Shit, that's what I'm saying. Be, like, motherfuckers don't
y'all
even
be watching,
read.
Y'all be got there watching them TV shows. The motherfuckers
no,
be reading
up on. No, I read books. I dead ass like, read
I ain't say y'all niggas didn't read. I'm just saying
y'all
that.
Y'all niggas don't read.
I don't. I read the stuff I want to read.
Thanks, babe.
That wasn't for you, Nico. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Come on, Nico. Damn.
Because I ain't not shit. Y'all niggas ain't shit.
Y'all talk to us until next week. Shit.
Now they mad at me because niggas ain't shit. God damn, I'm a nigga, niggas ain't shit. Justin, we ain't shit.
Now, Justin is a married man.
Justin, don't bring him in.
He's something.
Y'all, we out this thing. My next episode, we're going to turn him into a dog. Reese Young going to come on this mug. Y'all make sure y'all kick it. It's your boy Nico the Great and my wonderful co-host.
It's your girl, Yayo, the General. All right, bye.
Yeah.
I'm just talking shit. What a ghetto. What a ghetto.